Hi, I'm Matt from Duo Security. In this video, I'm going to show you how to integrate Duo with Cisco Identity Services Engine to add two-factor authentication. This application uses Radius and the Duo Authentication Proxy. Before watching this video, please read our documentation for integrating with Identity Services Engine, also known as ISE or ICE, at duo.com/docs/Cisco ISE-radius. For assistance with common troubleshooting issues, visit the Duo knowledge base at help.duo.com. Before starting, note that this Duo integration is compatible with Cisco ICE firmware version 2.4 or later. Before setting up this Duo integration, you must have a working primary authentication configuration for your ICE users. To integrate Duo with your Cisco ICE, you will need to install a local proxy service on a system within your network. This Duo proxy server also acts as a Radius server. There is usually no need to deploy a separate Radius server to use Duo. Before proceeding, you should locate or set up a system on which you will install the Duo authentication proxy. The proxy supports Windows Server 2012 R2 or later and Linux systems, in particular Red Hat Enterprise Linux 7 or later, CentOS 7 or later, or Debian 7 or later. The proxy can be installed on a physical or virtual host. We recommend a system with at least one CPU, 200 megabytes of disk space, and 4 gigabytes of RAM. In this video, we will deploy the proxy on a Windows system. After preparing your proxy system, you will need to create your Cisco ICE application in Duo. Open a web browser and log in to the Duo admin panel. In the left sidebar, click Applications. Then click Protect an Application. In the search bar, type in Cisco ISE. Next to the entry for Cisco ICE Radius, click Protect this application. This brings you to your new application's properties page. This page contains your integration key, secret key, and API hostname. You will need these later during setup. At the top of the properties page, click the link to open the Cisco ICE documentation. Next, install the Duo authentication proxy. On the system you want to install the proxy on, navigate to the Install the Duo Authentication Proxy section of the documentation. Click the link to download the most recent version of the proxy for Windows. Launch the installer on the server as a user with administrator rights and follow the on-screen prompts to complete installation. After the installation completes, configure and start the proxy. For the purposes of this video, we assume that you have some familiarity with the elements that make up the proxy configuration file and how to format them. Comprehensive descriptions of each of these elements are available in the documentation. The Duo authentication proxy configuration file is named authproxy.cfg and is located in the conf subdirectory of the proxy installation. Run a text editor like WordPad as an administrator and open the configuration file. By default, this file is stored in C, Program Files x86, Duo Security Authentication Proxy, conf. Since this is a completely new installation of the proxy, there may be example content in the configuration file. Delete this content. First, configure the proxy for your primary authenticator. For this example, we will use Active Directory. Add an AD_client section to the top of the configuration file. Add the host parameter and enter the host name or IP address of your domain controller. Then add the service account username parameter and enter the username of a domain member account that has permission to bind to your AD and perform searches. Next, add the service account password parameter and enter the password that corresponds to the username entered above. Finally, add the searchDN parameter and enter the LDAP distinguished name of an AD container or organizational unit containing all of the users you wish to permit to log in. Optional variables for this section are described in the documentation. Next, configure the proxy for your Cisco ICE. Create a radius_server_auto section below the AD_client section. Add the integration key, secret key, and API hostname from your Cisco ISE application's properties page in the Duo Admin panel. Add the radius IP1 parameter and enter the IP address of your Cisco ISE. Below that, add the radius secret 1 parameter and enter a secret to be shared between the proxy and your ISE. Add the client parameter and enter AD_client. Optional parameters for the radius server auto section are described in the documentation. Save your configuration file. Open an administrator command prompt and run net start duo auth proxy to start the proxy service. Next, configure your Cisco ISE. Log in to the Cisco ISE admin portal. Navigate to Administration, Network Resources, External Radius Servers. Click Add. In the Name field, enter Duo Radius. In the Host IP field, enter the host name or IP address of your Duo Authentication proxy. In the Shared Secret field, enter the secret used in your authentication proxy configuration. Set the authentication port to 1812 or whichever port you specified in your proxy configuration. Set the server timeout to 60. Click Submit to add the new server. Next, navigate to Administration, Network Resources, Radius Server Sequences. Click Add. In the Name field, enter Duo Radius Sequence. Under User Selected Service Type, in the Available section, select your newly added Duo Radius server and click the arrow to add it to the Selected section. Click Submit. Next, navigate to Policy, Policy Sets. Click the drop-down menu for the policy set that you want to change and select Duo Radius Sequence. Click Save to apply the change. Finally, test your setup. Launch the AnyConnect client and select the profile that now uses Duo Radius authentication. To test your setup, attempt to log in to your newly configured system as a user enrolled in Duo with an authentication device. When you enter your username and password, you will receive an automatic push or phone callback. As the example user has already installed and activated Duo Mobile on a smartphone and this integration utilizes an auto push configuration, you will receive a push notification on your smartphone. Open the notification on the smartphone, check the contextual information to confirm the login is legitimate, and tap the green button to accept. You are then logged in. Reference the documentation for more information about authentication options. You have successfully protected Cisco ISE with Duo.